in. Unconfirmed reports of an accident at Southland Park.
I can't find my boy!
Hundreds of family members gathered outside
rising
the deserted park today to commemorate the second anniversary of the Southland Park
at least
tragedy.
Pending a full investigation of the park's safety
authorities
procedures.
Report at least 30 deaths and close to 100 injuries.
5 years since the tragedy closed the gates of Southland Park, but new evidence
is claiming malicious prosecution and believes
says
he'll be vindicated
spent every
at last.
Penny of his fortune
the so-called
defending
Legal
himself
Eagles
from these
dream
lawsuits.
Team defending Southland Park owner Joe
Cobbins. There were people flying everywhere. It was body parts.
And the victims' families have vowed to appeal the decision.
Not guilty.
Cleared of all charges.
Come, have a cup of tea, hon. Sitting in the dark won't bring him back, sweetheart.
I would like to place an order.
This training level will introduce to you the various skills and techniques required to effectively undertake the mission.
Welcome to the States, 47. This should be a straightforward operation. We need you to penetrate an abandoned amusement park, locate the owner, and take him out. The target is a Joseph Clarence, also known as Swing King. An accident involving one of the rides at the park a few years back forced him to close it down. Our client has made a special request that the photograph you have in your possession be the last thing the target sees. Mr. Clarence has somehow become involved with a narcotics distribution ring, so the park may still have some amusements. Enjoy the ride, 47.
What the fuck you looking at, Kraken?
I'm here to see Joseph Clarence.
Never heard of
him. Mr. Swing King?
Oh, that sorry-ass dickhead. What the fuck they call you?
Names are for friends, so I don't need one.
crazy bastards go.
Gotta check you, white bread. No weapons past me, motherfucker. Gotta check you, white bread. All right, you cool.
I can get the money, sweetie. It's as good as mine already. Mr. Spook's got it. We'll open the park. It'll be like old times. No, no, just a few more days. You gotta believe me. Don't say that, sunshine. Mr. Spook's gonna come through, baby. He's good for the money. I won't sign the papers. I won't. You gotta give me one more chance. You gotta. Baby cakes? Sunshine? Hello?
It's been a while now, Scoop, and I was just wondering where we were on the whole money thing.
Were you?
Yeah, see, the thing is, if you remember, you know what we agreed to was it'd just be a short while and you'd pay in cash, and I know what the pressure was you were under must be, but the deal is a deal, and I was hoping, you know, maybe you could just pay what we agreed on, even though you've been here for, heck, more than twice as long as we agreed to, but just pay the original amount and move on. Not right away, necessarily, but, you know, I'd appreciate it.
No.
Who the hell are you? How'd you get in here? Carol Ann!
My client has hired me to show you this photograph.
I don't understand.
My client has asked me to ensure it's the last thing you ever see. Please, look at the photograph, Mr. Clarence.
No. Please. Haven't I suffered enough? Don't you think I...
Yeah. Rick Henderson, first edition?
He's expecting you. This way.
Rick Henderson, I've been looking forward to this.
As have I, Mr. Alexander.
Don't let's stand on ceremony. Call me Jack.
Rick.
Make yourself comfortable, Rick. I'll be right with you. I admire your work. Real journalism.
Thanks. I thought we'd start with your thoughts on the White House attack, then discuss your tenure as director of the FBI, post-retirement reflections, whatever, and...
Rick.
Or if you want to sound off on politics...
Rick, my apologies. This interview about me is just a cover for a more sensitive story. I'm sorry to have lured you here under false pretenses, but I couldn't risk a leak.
I'm not sure I understand.
Don't worry. It's the scoop of the century.
If I had a dime for every time I heard that...
Listen, please. It begins with a little incident at a vineyard in Chile that caught my eye some time ago. This was a family business. Fernando Delgado and his son Manuel. Well-liked, hard-working men. Have a look at the folder.
Hello, 47. Your next target's in Chile. His name is Fernando Delgado. Used to be a colonel in Pinochet's intelligence service. Now he's running a cocaine factory under cover of a vineyard. Satellite imaging suggests the lab is underground. Fernando's son, Manuel, is on the coke trade. So to make it look like a drug hit, you'll have to take him out too. We'll get you in with a pensioner's club from Santiago for the big celebrity unveiling of Delgado's new wine label, named for 80s B-action star Rex Stanton. There'll be at least one TV crew on hand, so keep an eye on them and their cameras. Delgado's got a seaplane, and that may be your best way to get out in a pinch.
Propiedad privada. No las estupideces, hermano.
Se ve más grande la televisión.
El cine norteamericano Rex Stanton se presentará en la finca. Se esperan miles de aficionados para disfrutar del libro de la comida gratis, más la posibilidad de encontrarse con el héroe musculoso de Motor City Massacre.
Yourself.